Amen. Now, while Jesus was on the earth, Jesus functioned as a man. Now, he was the Son of God, but that's not how he operated. So everything you see Jesus doing, he's doing as a man. And he's living his life and doing things in the way we're supposed to live and in the way we're supposed to function. So Jesus is actually the prototype of humanity. He's the model after which we are copies. Just like he lived, that's how we're supposed to live. Just like he operated, that's how we're supposed to operate. He operated as a man in relationship with the Father. And we're supposed to operate in the same manner. Now, that means that just like you saw Jesus submitting to the Father in all things, that's how we're supposed to be in submission to him in all things. And just like we see Jesus exercising authority and dominion over Satan, over sickness, over demons, over lack, over sin, that's how we're supposed to exercise authority and dominion. Amen. Jesus himself said to his disciples, he said, look, I give you authority to tread upon serpents and over scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. So Jesus, this authority that I have, I delegate it to you. Just like the Father has given me authority to operate in this earth as a man, I give you the same authority. The same authority I have, I give it to you. Amen? Before he ascended, he said, all authority in heaven and earth is given unto me. And he says, now you go. Go in this authority and lo, I'll be with you. So the same authority that he walked in, the same dominion he exercised, guess what? We're supposed to walk in that. We're supposed to exercise it. Now, the question is, why aren't we getting the same results that Jesus got? And I believe the answer is simple. We don't have and we don't walk in the level of revelation concerning who we are that he had. The problem is Jesus knew who he was. He had full revelation concerning who he was. And he walked in that revelation. Unfortunately, we don't yet have that same revelation. And so that is hindering the way we walk and the way we live. And then Jesus actually believed. Without doubt, he believed what God has said concerning him. Unfortunately, our faith is not where it needs to be. It's not a question of whether we have the authority. It's that we have it. It's not that we don't have the kind of power and can't walk in, and we can. But what is hindering or limiting our experience of that authority and power is our limited revelation and our unbelief. And so what we need to be working on is more revelation and to get rid of unbelief. So one day Jesus came down from the Mount of Transfiguration. He met his disciples trying to cast out a devil that they couldn't cast out. And they said, Lord, why couldn't we cast this out? And Jesus said, because of your unbelief. In other words, you should be able to do this, but the reason that you're not doing this is because of unbelief. And then he turns to them, he said, now this kind doesn't come out except by prayer and fasting. Now some people say that's that kind of type of demon requires fasting, prayer and fasting. I don't believe that. I believe Jesus told me that kind of unbelief. Amen. This kind of unbelief that is hindering you from walking in this kind of authority to get all, you need prayer and fasting. So that's the purpose of prayer and fasting, is not to move God, it's to get rid of the unbelief that hinders us from walking in authority and power. The problem is not God. God is already moved. God's already persuaded folks. We don't need to have to convince God. Our problem is unbelief limits us. Unbelief hinders us from receiving what God has given and from walking in what God has given to us. So if we want to walk in a greater manifestation of his authority and power, we've got to deal with ignorance and we've got to deal with unbelief. Those are the enemies that we confront. Spiritual warfare, in essence, is that for us. Doing what we need to do to get rid of ignorance and overcome unbelief.